time that I see people either dedicating their children or getting baptized, I'm just very, very happy. And this is a joyful day that we're here to celebrate. So if you have your Bible, go to Matthew chapter 28. If you don't, it's okay. It's projected on the screen. So today I want to share Matthew 28, and the title is Do Not Be Afraid. I'm going to start with a story. This story continues from last Friday. How many of you were here last Friday for Good Friday? Jiahui Good Friday service. Okay, wow. Okay, a lot of you. Now, Good Friday, we talk about Easter Bunny. So this is a continuation of Easter Bunny. Okay. There's a man driving on the freeway and driving on a highway. And all of a sudden, he saw the Easter Bunny. 就看到这个复活节的兔子. And the 复活节兔子看起来, you know, it's kind of going crazy. 他就 jumped just across the road. Now the man is trying not to hit the Easter Bunny, so he had to try to avoid it. 但是 Easter Bunny 就像发疯一样，就跳到他的车面前，所以他就没有办法就撞到这 Easter Bunny. 然后这 Easter Bunny 就飞出去，然后他就 anyway, it's not rated R, don't worry, okay. 所以他就下去看说，哇, what happened to this Easter Bunny? 就他去看, you know, very sad, Easter Bunny has died. 所以他就 the man was really sad, and you know, he stood by the road and don't know what to do. There's a woman driving by. 他就看到 there's a man sitting by the side of the road. So he said, well, what happened? Now the man was very sad. Say, you know, I accidentally hit the Easter Bunny and I killed it. 然后the woman就说, don't worry, I know what to do. I know the exact thing to do for the Easter Bunny. 所以他就拿了这个一个can，他就从他这边拿出一个 spray can，然后就 spray 在这个 Easter Bunny。 就喷在这 Easter Bunny 上，然后这 Easter Bunny 就活起来，然后就开始 jump 之后，他就 wave， 哎，然后就大概又 jump 了 50 meter， 然后又 wave， 然后又 jump 50 meter， 又 wave， 然后就越 jump 就跳走了。然后 the man was so amazed, like, you know, what is in that spray can？ 是什么喷的东西可以让这个 bunny 可以就这样子活起来呢？所以他就拿过来看，就发现那个 spray can 上面呢，其实是有一个 typo。 那 typo 就写 hair spray， restore life to dead hair, add permanent wave。 I know it's a lame joke. Anyway, you know, it's only every year, right, I almost preach every year on Easter. There's only so many Easter jokes. So if you have any good Easter joke, welcome to email me, right? There's only so many of them I can use. Now, but today, I know it's lame, but today we are going to talk about resurrection. We are going to talk about being from death to life. We are going to talk about 主耶稣基督的复活. On Friday, the Friday service, we talk about how Jesus died and crucified on the cross. And today we'll review part of it by inviting Yuan to sing again the song Why. 那我们邀请袁可以到台上为我们. And the song is talking about what Jesus has done for us through an eye of a little girl. 他跟他爸爸在 Jerusalem 的 street 上面所看到, so this is from the perspective of a little girl. 你可以放这个 PowerPoint. Thank you. So we talk about Jesus was crucified to death, buried in a tomb. And today we're going to continue the story as Jesus was buried in a tomb outside of the city of Jerusalem. And this is the story continued in Matthew chapter 28, verse 1. Matthew chapter 28, verse 1. Today's projection is CE and NASB, but you will come to read your own version. I'm going to read 中文的新译本. 过了安息日，在礼拜日天亮的时候，抹大拉的玛利亚和另一个玛利亚来看坟墓. So it's, the Bible said there are two women, 就是 Mary Magdalene 跟 the other Mary. Now, this is quite confusing because there are actually four Marys in the story of Jesus. I guess it was a very popular name at that time, right? It's like, hey, honey, what do you want to name our baby daughter? I can't think of one. Let's call her Mary, right? It's kind of like, 就是你知道，在中国、台湾以前 Chinese people 就是以前很多人叫美丽啊什么，对不对？就是想不出来。I hope I don't offend anyone, okay? But 以前有时候想不出来，就叫什么？哎，就叫美丽，就 Mary, right? 没有啦。 Okay. Now the first one. The first Mary is Jesus, Jesus' mother. Whenever I see that, 连 Daniel 都受不了的笑话, so I know it's like I crossed the line. First one is Jesus' mother, and that's Mary, Virgin Mary. 第二个 Mary, 可能很多人认识她，就是 Martha 跟 Lazarus, 马大跟拉撒路的姐妹. 第三个 Mary 就是我们刚刚讲到的 Mary Magdalene， 她是抹大拉的玛利亚。那抹大拉是一个地方 ，Magdalene 是一个地方。这个地方 is known for prostitute， 因为它就是在 roadside， 它不是一个 large town。I've been there， you know， when I went to Israel， 它是一个 very small town， 所以它只是在路过的地方有一个，所以它是大部分人就是在那边 stay one night and leave。 So that town is known for prostitute。 Now we're not sure， completely sure， but most scholars believe that she was a prostitute。 But we are sure that there are demons casted out of her。 所以这个是第三个 Mary。 The fourth Mary is disciple John and James 的 mother， 她 happened to also 也叫 Mary。 然后 most people believe that 她是 cousin to Jesus 的 mother， 所以就是 everyone is called Mary。 Okay， anyway， now the Mary that mentioned here， 在我们刚刚读到的就是 第三个 Mary number three 跟 Mary number four， 就是 Mary Magdalene 跟 John 跟 James 的妈妈，这第三跟第四个 Mary。 So these two Mary， 我们刚刚讲到，他们就是进到这边要去看 Jesus， 的这个 Jesus 的 dead body。 Now the story continuing in verse 2， 他说忽然地震很厉害，主的使者从天上下来，把石头裂开，坐在上面。他的样子好像闪电，衣服洁白如雪。看守的人因为害怕他，就浑身颤抖，好像死了一样。 In verse 5， 那个使者就对妇女们说：“你们不要怕，我知道你们在找被钉十字架的耶稣，他不在这里，已经照他所说的复活了。你们来看安放他的地方吧。” 你快去告诉他的门徒，他已经从死人中复活，他会比你们先到加利利去。你们在那里必看见他。现在我已经告诉你们了。Story continuing in verse 8， 他们立刻离开坟墓，又害怕，十分欢喜，跑去告诉耶稣的门徒。忽然耶稣向他们迎面而来，说：“你们好。”他们就上前抱住他的脚，拜他。耶稣对他们说：“不要怕，去告诉我的弟兄，叫他们到加利利去，在那里必看见我。” The first point, there are only two points today, and in between I'll ask Rachel to share her testimony. The first point I want to talk about is you are important in God's eyes. Now, we just saw 这个刚刚的, we just read this verse. 这个verse当中他说这个angel就对这些woman说, okay, this is after Jesus Christ has risen from the dead. The most important news in the history of mankind. 这个 good news. Angel 呢, 他 chose to spoke to 谁呢? Chose to spoke to this woman. 他说, go and tell Jesus' disciples. 然后其实我们都知道, Jesus has many disciples, right? Hundreds of them. And there were 12 that was closest to Jesus. And among the 12, there were 3 that was his core, Peter, James, and John, right? So, but the angel did not choose to tell this good news to any of the disciples first. He chose to tell the woman. Why is that? And continue. 接下来耶稣又跟他们说 Again, it's like, okay, the point was not made enough. 所以现在就有这个耶稣他就要 make 一个 point. If I didn't make the point strong enough, 耶稣他现在自己又 didn't go to his disciples. 这几个 woman 就是要 run to disciples 嘛。Middle of the way, 耶稣又出现说 Okay, do not be afraid. Now go tell my disciples. It's not like the message was not clear enough. 耶稣自己又说了一遍。So why did the angel and Jesus, why did both of them, 第一个就是 tell this woman? Obviously, they can tell the disciples themselves, right? I mean, angels, it's not too hard for the angel to travel from here to there to tell disciples, right? So why the woman?Right, it must be because they're gossipers, so it just news spread 比较快 right? No, of course not, right? I'm sure that's not the reason. Now, we have to think about women at that time. 女生在那个时候是怎么样? They have no social status. They does not get education. 他们没有受任何的教育. Usually, they do not make any income. Women could not join the religious ceremony.They could not serve during the religious event. Jewish woman, 犹太人的这些女生, they could not go inside the temple. If you know the temple well, that temple 它有一个 outside court, 叫外邦人跟女人的院, right? It's for Gentiles and women. 所以对 Jewish woman 来说, people treated them just like they're not Jewish. They're not even Jewish people. 所以 they can't even go inside the temple. In fact,They cannot even go into the synagogue. 他们不只是不能进 Holy Temple, 他们也不能进去他们地方的会堂。They're basically a lower class. They cannot own land or property. Their name is not recorded in the genealogy. 在家谱里面不会有他们的名字。Last year, I went to Israel in Jerusalem. This is one of the most holy places. You probably, 也许有些人知道这是 Wailing Wall, 哭墙。Right? 在Wailing Wall 呢 ？Even till today, okay. By the way, Wailing Wall 哭墙是 the only remnant of the Holy Temple, 就是圣殿剩下唯一的东西，圣殿已经没有了。那 even till today, men and women are separated. They cannot be together. 所以这边是男生，这边是女生。There's a wall between them. They cannot go to the same section of the wall. 在男生这边的 wall 呢 ？Okay, 这边是男生，那女生在这个 picture 底下 ，you don't see it. 这个男生的地方 is so much bigger compared to the woman's side. Not only that, 男生的地方有一个这个 entrance. 这 entrance goes into where? Well, 女生你们永远都进不去。So let me tell you what's inside of this.Originally, I thought we cannot, 所以我跟 Nathan 以为我们不能进去。然后我就其实很喜欢，那我就说，我就进去看看。结果还可以进去。所以 what is inside? Inside 呢是有很多他们的 holy books. See, everyone, even 小朋友都可以进去 but you have to be a boy. They have books there. They have people worship there. And they have the most holy, 对他们来说最 holy 的那个代表上帝。上帝 has no idol, so this is the holiest place for Jewish people, and it's there. Now, women cannot get close to this place. Women cannot even enter this room, cannot even enter that side. So even till today, the culture is women cannot worship God as close as men do. Well, it's funny that at church now, a lot of times women have more intimate relationship with God, right? So the culture is women cannot be close to God because woman is lower class. That was the culture at that time. And to a large part, it's still the culture in Israel, in Jewish culture. Women are marginalized in a society at that time. 是一个社会的边缘人。Women were treated not to be important and not to be valuable. Now, Mary Magdalene, 抹大拉的玛利亚她更是被人家看不起的一个女人。我们知道刚刚讲到 she was probably a prostitute. 所以今天她的名字 Mary Magdalene, that's not a praise. It's like, 既然 Vivian 坐在这我就用 Vivian 坐。It's like, 红灯区的 Vivian, right? Vivian from the red light district. It's basically, that's what the name means, right? I'm sure Vivian is very, 对, Mac 不用担心, it's just an example. We don't know if she was a former prostitute, but we know she is, well, not Mary, okay? We don't know if Mary was, but, 但是我们知道 Mary, 她是被人家看成是一个 unclean 的 woman. And 在 Luke chapter 8, 自己在这边有讲到, this is about Mary Magdalene. 她说有恶鬼, 她在抹大拉的这个玛利亚身上有 seven demons, seven evil spirits have been casted out from Mary Magdalene. So we know this Mary, 她是一个社会的边缘人. And if you read this, 刚刚我们所读到的, 是 Mary Magdalene 和 the other Mary, right? This Mary is not even important enough to mention who she is, right? Especially the other girl, right? The other Mary. So you see that, 其实她说这个另外这个意思是什么? 另外这个 Mary, 就是 she's not even in the inner circle. She's not even in the core. You know, 这两个人, not only that they were women, they were the socially marginalized, 社会的边缘人, they were the marginalized of the marginalized. 因为你知道, Jesus' disciples 其实已经是 a group of people that's usually not welcome to the society. 他们已经是一群 marginalized 的人. Even among them, 他们都还不是那个 core, right? Even 在 Jesus 的这些 follower 当中, 他们都是在那些边缘的人. 但是, but Jesus, the first thing that when Jesus resurrected, he didn't go to the disciples. He didn't tell the disciples. Yet he chose to tell these women. And he said, go tell my disciples. Because Jesus loved to use people who are undeserving. Jesus loved to show himself. Jesus loved to show his face to those who think I'm not worthy. Jesus loved to show his face to everyone. I think Jesus is trying to make a point here. He loved to show his face to everyone. He loves to speak to everyone. It doesn't matter if you are in an inner circle. If you're not successful by the world's standard, that's okay. And maybe even at church, you're not part of the inner circle. You're not part of the core. And maybe some of you feel like you have been rejected by others, by your friends, by family, by people around you, and maybe even when you come to church, you feel that you've been rejected. But hey, Jesus loves you. The message that the angel in Jesus is trying to convey here is that Jesus loves you, and Jesus wants to talk to you, and he even wants to use you to bless others. It doesn't matter your achievement in society system. It doesn't matter, even light out church, sometimes you feel you're being rejected, but Jesus loves you the same. Oh, 我要看一个小的 video. Now this video is only in English. This is a testimony of a broken person.
So I grew up in a middle class home. We went to church on Sundays. Most of the time it wasn't because I was looking for God, it was because I was looking for friends. Well, I went to college, that's when I was introduced to drugs. Cocaine became very popular for me. Just the whole bar atmosphere I chose to dive right into. You know, I graduated, found a job that I really started succeeding at. I was actually promoted to that job to take on different levels of responsibility around the nation. And one of my first deployments was back in my college hometown. I'd been there for about a month and a half. And I ran into a really good friend of mine from college. We decided that we were going to a Jimmy Buffett concert. You know, we left and we were drinking and we were just having fun in the car. It was a college road trip, if you will, except we never really made it to the destination. When we hit the tree, my friend looked through the windshield. And the young lady that was with us was thrown about 20 to 35 yards. She's maimed to this day. My friend obviously died. And I broke 27 bones, including 4, 5, and 6 in my vertebrae. You know, I'll never forget the day that my parents had to come in rehab. And they had the conversation that it was very possible that I was going to jail for 40 years for intoxicated manslaughter, intoxicated assault. When I left the hospital, chose to go home with my parents, and I remember the guilt hit me like a mack truck. I can't describe to you how far away from God I felt. Instead of turning to Jesus, I turned to more drugs, turned to more alcohol. I was on a mission to hurt myself even more. There was a girl that I was dating at this restaurant, and she came to me one day, and I'll never forget, and she said, I'm pregnant. I remember a prayer of God, if you really don't like me this much, why are you hurting her? I remember thinking I was his guinea pig, that he was just going to abuse me, and that for some reason I drowned the short straw because of the bad things I'd done in my life. I was so sure that he was so mad at me. I was so sure that I had nothing to offer. I was so sure that I had crossed the line and that I couldn't go back. It was about 3 months after that we decided to get married, much to everybody's chagrin. And during this time, God had started sending Christian men into my life, and they took interest in me. And then they would help me, and they would guide me in the right direction. I ended up going to trial, and the judge stopped everything. He looked me square in the eye, and he said, you know, Mr. Germer, I see a lot of these cases a year. He said, but there's something sort of different here. Can you tell me, are you in a program? Are you doing anything? What seems to be helping you? And I remember sitting there for a second and dropping my head. And before I knew it, I looked up and I said, Jesus Christ. And you know, in a lot of ways, that was the first time I think I ever felt peace. In a lot of ways, I think that was the only time I ever felt that things were going to be okay. I was left with restitution. I was left with probation. I was left with some jail time. And I had to go AA twice a week. Even though I was starting to experience freedom in my walk, it was probably the hardest one because I was dealing with all the emotions that I had always shoved down through my drug addiction. I was walking through all those emotions and whatever that had done to other people's lives. It was like this tornado that just ripped through everything and got to the other side when I got sober and thought everything was okay. I'd been in AA for about a year when my pastor called me in, asked me to take over for Celebrate Recovery. It was at our church. And I remember looking at him saying, are you kidding me? I'm barely functioning as it is, and you want me to lead something? And I remember that night going home and praying with my wife, as excited as we were. I remember my prayer of, God, you can't use me. How could you believe in me enough to do this? Don't you know what I've done? I can barely run my own life, very much run a ministry for you. There's no possible way. Over the next 4 years, the Celebrate Recovery that I had been asked to be the ministry leader of grew from 40 people to 150. And there were stories of freedom all around, but it was one step at a time. It was one Friday night at a time. It was one meeting at a time. As God started showing me that he could use somebody that was broken.
Now, I don't know what's your story, but I think the message that God chose this woman is because God wants to send out a message that everyone is important and you are important in God's eyes. And we're going to invite Rachel, who's a woman, to come up and share her testimony as she is getting baptized later today.
今天很高兴终于下定决心要受洗，然后我其实是从小就去教会了，是我是那种 Christian family background 的那种，但是就觉得就是见证也见过蛮多的，也听过很多，所以就觉得受洗就一定要可能是有什么奇迹发生啊，可能就是从被神救回来那种的，所以我就一直就 expect 我可能生命中也会有那么奇妙的事情， 但是可能就觉得，所以就一直在等，因为我十八岁的时候，对，我十八岁的时候，我的辅导有问过我要不要去受洗，因为我其实从就是一直都有参加教会的fellowship， 但是之后其他人都受洗了，可能参加大概两三个月之后就神就感动他们，之后他们就受洗，之后辅导，所以辅导就问我，但是我那时候就想说，那好吧，就是 under 一些 pressure， 那好吧，我就上那个受洗班，但是上到一半的时候，我跟我家人讲，但是我爸爸就说你还小，你还不知道你在干嘛，所以就没有同意我受洗啊，对，所以就最后也没有受洗。之后从 Temple City 来到 Irvine 读书，就去了这个教会，也是就是在这个团契，他们也知道我其实从小都有去教会，好紧张。然后我的小组长啊辅导也有问过我要不要受洗，我就那时候就想说我好像在等一些什么的，等一些可能神又什么在我在谷底下面又救我那种奇迹吧，对啊，所以就对一直在等等等等等，但是都好像没什么事情发生，当然就是中间有一段时间是跟就可能受到神的试探吧，就是觉得为什么这些事情会发生在我身上走的，但是我其实心里面一直都没有放弃，就是 believing in God， 一直就是可能有某段时间我是很少去教会啊，或者就是没有读圣经，但是就是沉淀自己一下，对啊，然后可能机缘巧合 ，Sophia 我的小组长，就两个礼拜前就问我说，哦，你有没有想过就是要受洗啊？复活节快来了，就他希望我在复活节受洗。之后我就想了一下，就说，哦，那好吧，因为可能我再拖的时候也是结果也差不多，所以就就不会 expect 有什么东西出现的，就觉得。Yeah, maybe I am just afraid of commitment. 所以，对啊，所以就决定要受洗今天。而且我很高兴我的妈妈啊，我的 family 可以参加。我远，这是从香港远来的阿嬷也来了，谢谢。
Is do not be afraid. Now, if we go back to 这个 verse, 其实他在 repeat 的东西其实很简单。First of all, the angel said to the women, "Do not be afraid, for he has risen, for Jesus has risen, and you will see him." Then later, 他们就往耶稣这边跑的往就是要去往 disciples 那边跑的时候 ，Jesus 又自己出来，他基本上讲的 exact same thing。他说 "Do not be afraid and go there and you will see me." So the message is the same. It's being repeated. Do not be afraid. Jesus has risen and you will see Jesus. Now the message was 2,000 years ago for these women, but it's still for you and me today. And this is actually something important that Jesus was repeating. First of all, why were they afraid? 他们在怕什么呢？ Well, number one, they saw supernatural things. They saw the angel. So for us, maybe some of you do have some supernatural experience, whether it's good or bad. Maybe that is part of your fear. The second thing that these women, they were afraid of because they could not find Jesus' body. They don't know what's going on.And for us, maybe you're also going through some time that's things don't go as planned or things don't go as expected, you're also going through a confusing time. All the followers of Jesus, 所有耶稣的跟随者, they were all afraid at that time because they just lost their beloved leaders. The Roman and the Jewish religious leader were persecuting them. 他们正在被迫害. They're going through a hardship. They were lost. They had no hope and no direction. And maybe that's true for a lot of us here. Every one of us, the moment that mankind loses the intimate relationship with God, when Adam and Eve sin and leave God, when they decided not to follow God, we all started to have fear in one form or another. And that's why after Adam and Eve, 他们犯罪之后, 他们跟神之间就开始有fear. The conversation Jesus, 上帝问说, Adam, 你在哪里? Adam说什么呢? 说, I was afraid, and I was naked. Fear跟shame, 害怕跟羞愧, ever since that time, it's been in everyone's heart in one way or another. We have been afraid. We all have something that we're afraid of. And I'm not just talking about a phobia, or something like that. I'm talking about everyone. You know, if you're not afraid of ghosts, then maybe you're afraid of dark. If you're not afraid of darkness, maybe you're afraid of death. If not death, maybe loneliness. If not loneliness, maybe insecurity. Maybe it's losing your health or losing your beauty or losing your youth. Maybe you're afraid of rejection. Maybe it's losing friends. Losing status, maybe it's losing loved ones, or maybe losing love. You know, we always wanted to, when we were young, do my parents love me? Then later, do my friends love me? Then do my boyfriend or girlfriend love me? Do my spouse love me? Then do my children love me? Maybe it's not afraid of not making enough money, or maybe not making enough money for retirement or for our children. We all have something that we fear in one way or another. Because when men are created by God, we are spiritually covered by God. 上帝给人一个自然的一个 natural spiritual cover. And when men decide that we're not going to follow God anymore, when we decide not to serve God and not to follow God, when we rejected God, as a consequence, we also reject that spiritual cover over us. 当人不要接受上帝的时候, 我们自然就拒绝了上帝要给我们的那个 natural cover. When we don't have that cover, we become naked. When we're naked, we feel shame and we feel fear as a natural consequence. So the first thing after Jesus was resurrected, he had risen from the dead, the angel said, do not fear. Because he has risen, you're going to see him. Then Jesus said the same thing himself, do not be afraid. Why was Jesus repeating? Is it because he didn't trust the angels? It's like, if you want to get something done, you better do it yourself, right? No, of course not, right? I mean, how hard was it for the angel to remember this line? Do not be afraid. Go to Galilee. You're going to see Jesus there. It's not too hard. I'm sure angels can remember that. Why did Jesus repeat that again? Because it was an important message for you and for me, and not just for the woman at that time. Because when our relationship with God was not as intimate, we all lived in some form of fear in our life. And maybe for some of us, we have this fear, we don't know where we're going to go after we die. So Jesus wants you to know, do not be afraid, for I have risen, and I want to meet you, and you are going to meet me. I want to see you, and I want you to see me. For you can restore your relationship with God. And even if you still have fear in life, after you know God, believe me, God, little by little, you can restore that spiritual cover God has and wants to prepare for you. Let us pray. Father, this morning as we come to celebrate your resurrection, 我们庆祝你的复活在我们的中间. Father, there are two messages today that you want to let everyone know. Number one, everyone, you are important in God's eyes. It doesn't matter if you have been rejected, God loves you, and God wants to see you, and God wants to meet you. The second message is do not be afraid. I don't know what is your fear. I don't know what are the things that you have anxiety or stress or you're not sure about. But Jesus is saying, do not be afraid, for I have risen, and I want you to see me. And I want to see you. Do not be afraid. And this, if today's message touches your heart, that you want to follow Jesus more closely, you want to restore that cover God has provided and intends to provide for you, and if that's your prayer, 我邀请你在座位上举起你的手, I want to pray for you today. 举完就可以放下。 I want to pray for my brother and sister. In the name of Jesus, we cast out fear, we cast out anxiety, stress, accusation, unworthiness. Everyone is worthy, is precious in God's eyes. Because when Jesus has risen, He casts out the fear in us. I'm here to proclaim that God, you're going to restore, whether little by little or fast, you're going to restore the spiritual cover for all my brothers and sisters. So that fear cannot overcome us, for you have risen.相信今天Rachel会站在这里要受洗，其实从小她的家人就是对她，我相信是一个很大的影响。那今天也很感谢她的家人、她的阿嬷、她的妈妈在这里。那我们也请是不是有Rachel的母亲，可以有简短几句话可以来对Rachel要说的。
我很高兴Rachel能够决定要受浸。 然后加入神的家，这是我很大的希望，也是很感谢天父在照顾他，然后也很感谢神带领他的妈妈来到这边看他的见证，谢谢。
那我们就请 Rachel 的长辈，然后他的小组长跟牧师，我们可以按手在 Rachel 的身上。今天其实之前大时刻的历任的小组长也都在这里中 ，Holly 肖，然后Nicole她今天不能够来，因为她在out of town， 但是她用她的 community pool 来祝福我们。那我们就请就是 Sylvia， Pastor Andy， 也请如果他的阿嬷或是他的母亲愿意的话，我们就按手在 Rachel 的身上，我们就一起同声开口来为 Rachel 来做祝福的祷告。那我们其他人也伸出我们的手来为 Rachel 来做祝福。那之后我就请他的小组长 Sylvia 来为，那我们就请他的母亲好不好？ 就请阿姨来为您的女儿来做祝福的祷告，我们就一起同声开口来为 Rachel 来祷告。最后我请阿姨来做结束。那不求我们在今天早上的这一刻，也请带领 Rachel 在她从小的信仰，她今天要带多的信仰来祝福，可以来带领她前面的道路，可以来牵着她的手，可以来坚定她的信仰，然后也帮助她继续来认识你。 但是他对你的信心是一生不改变的，求你让他一世一世都不离开你。
感谢天父一直带领志玲在这个神的家里面，然后就。 我们实在是很感谢，因为佢的妈妈唔识听普通话，所以我讲广东话。我希望Rachel 佢能够 在主耶稣里面一直令到跟随主耶稣来到见证神是几咁爱他，他亦都是怎样将主耶稣的爱来到带给一些未相信的人。我们这样祈祷是奉主耶稣基督的名字。
Amen。在马太福音28:18-20，耶稣说：“天上地下所有的权柄都赐给我了，所以你们要去，使万民做我的门徒，奉父子圣灵的名给他们施洗。凡我所吩咐你们的，都教训他们遵守。我就常与你们同在，直到世界的末了。”在五旬节的时候，彼得也对众人说：“你们个人要悔改，奉耶稣基督的名受洗，叫你们的罪得赦，就必领受所赐的圣灵。”因为这应许是给你们和你们的儿女，并一切在远方的人，就是主我们上帝所招来的人。当时彼得叫人悔改，信耶稣基督受洗。今日我也对 Rachel 说，你当深信，你若真实悔改，告白你的信仰，奉他的名受洗，这圣礼就要成为你的罪得赦的记号，表明从圣灵得重生与基督相连结的印证。现在在众人和上帝的面前，那 Rachel 有几句话要来问你，来告白你的信仰。 Rachel， 你是否信上帝为创造宇宙万物的造物主，也是你的天父，圣灵是你的 counselor， 来带领你的人生？你是否诚心信靠耶稣基督为我们的罪死在十字架上，愿意承认自己是罪人，悔改认罪，并且接受他做你的救主和生命的主？你当依靠主耶稣复活的大能来过生活，借着上帝的恩典尽力服侍他，一生行他的道，尽信徒的本分，你愿意如此行吗？我愿意。我们的教会是注重人人传福音的教会，你是否愿意遵行主的大使命，将福音介绍给未信的亲朋好友？那因为等一下你起来就会很湿，所以我们先请我们的一点五代的长老 Andy 来代表教会给你的受洗证书和教会送你的圣经。好，那我们就到这个池边。
好。
父神，我们真的是何等的喜乐，我们看到你。在过去你带领 Rachel 认识你，他从小就认识你，但他在今天他愿意在上帝和众人的面前来承认他的信仰，他愿意让他一生是让主耶稣基督做他人生的主，来带领他前面的道路。我在这里也奉主耶稣基督的圣名来宣告，你要带领 Rachel 继续来认识你，更深的来跟随你，并且是 passionately 的在跟随你，也愿你在他未来若遇到怀疑、遇到困难的时候，他对你的信仰是不改变的，他对你的信任是不改变的。也许他的生活有高有低，但是愿你的爱永远都够他所用。祷告奉主耶稣基督的名。在这里奉圣父、圣子、圣灵的名为 Rachel Ho 施洗，归入主的名下。是带领你，愿你在他的里面成为全新的，奉主耶稣基督的名 ，Amen。平常很怕水吗？
不是啊，不会，我
准备。